It was a daring rescue. An 80-year-old man pulled from his burning car just moments before it exploded. He's alive tonight, thanks to a Good Samaritan who looked through the tinted windows of the van, saw the man struggling, and then just jumped right into action. 11 News reporter Kerry Cavanaugh live in Northwest Baltimore with their story. Kerry?
Waverly Portis has been catching the bus here to work at the Weinberg place for the past 3 years. And during that time, he tells us that he's rarely been late. Well, today he missed his bus and he had to wait 8 minutes for the next one. And it turns out that short delay just may have saved the life of a man he encountered in the parking lot. As Donald Butler sits down to dinner, he has much to be thankful for.
We appreciate it.
Yes.
I do.
Take a look at the scorched asphalt where his van was parked a few hours earlier. Lucky for him, Waverly Portis, the maintenance man at Weinberg Senior Living, happened to be walking towards the lot when the van caught fire.
And it was smoke. But then I could see him sitting in it. From here, I could see him.
Portis was the only person who realized the 80-year-old was sitting inside the flaming van, and he knew he didn't have much time to get him out.
And I just pulled the door open. And I just grabbed him and said, "So we gotta go. It's gonna blow. We gotta go."
I don't even think he was thinking about himself. He was really thinking about me, you know.
Portis says it took some maneuvering to move the virtual stranger to safety.
And I was pulling, like, "We gotta go. We gotta go." And I was dragging as much as I can because, like I said, he's double my size.
The two men made it to the other side of the parking lot where they watched the van explode.
You got right over there. That's when it was boof.
Looking at the charred remains, the veteran of two wars says this fire is the closest brush he's had with death.
Is he a hero?
Oh, more than that. God and angel.
Yeah. I'm not saying I'm a hero, but, you know, it makes me feel good because I know I did something good for somebody today.
Mr. Butler tells us firefighters aren't sure what caused his van to catch on fire. As for Portis, he was back to work within an hour of that rescue. Reporting live in Northwest Baltimore, I'm Kerry Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.